We're doing it. Another tutorial. This time we're gonna talk about how to color grade your footage. And for the very first time on this channel, we will have a giveaway. For the past couple of weeks, I've been testing this editing panel that Loupedeck sent to me. And trust me, oh boy, it made my grading and editing process so much faster. You will see in this video why. And because I love that so much, I asked them, hey fellas at Loupedeck, could we do a little giveaway on my channel to get a Loupedeck Plus like this one to the squad out there that's always watching my videos? And they were like, of course, dude. So make sure to stick around and find out how to get your hands on one of these. But now let's jump into the tutorial. Let's answer one important question first. Why do you want to color grade your footage? In my humble opinion, there are three reasons. First, you want to achieve this cinematic look, and that look doesn't come straight out of the camera. Color grading will enable you to emulate the look we know and love from our favorite movies and also up your production value. Second, you can leverage colors to set the mood and subtly influence the viewer's perception and emotions. It's also a creative tool to convey additional information of your story. For example, in the movie classic, The Matrix, scenes that take place in The Matrix had a monochromic green tint, while scenes in the real world had a more natural look. And third, you can create your own look, and if consistently applied to your footage, people may start saying, oh hey, this is a Sam Calder video, this is a Peter McKinnon video, oh hey, this is fill in your own name video, purely by the look of the image. Now in this video, I will introduce you to the process that I use to color correct and grade my footage, which I learned from shadowing professional colorists and by watching hundreds of YouTube videos so that you don't have to do it. You're welcome. So before we get into the nitty-gritty of this tutorial, we have to understand the basics and do some homework and understand what is the difference between color correction and color grading. Color correction is the process in which you get all your various clips, all your footage, to the same base level, a natural, true-to-life image. Once you have all your clips corrected and matched, you can go into color grading, arguably the more fun part. This is where you give your footage the look you want to achieve, apply LUTs, and do the final pass. This is getting hot in the sweater. Anyways, if you're planning on color grading your footage, and I assume you want to do this, otherwise what's the point in watching this video? You want to shoot in a logarithmic picture profile. Log is a flat, desaturated image profile that gives you the widest dynamic range and the highest flexibility in the color grading process. But straight out of camera, log images look completely dull, so let's have a look on how to bring life into these frames. The color grading process is compiled of three steps. Set the contrast and exposure, naturalize colors and white balance, and nail the saturation. A little side note, for this tutorial, I'll be using footage from my upcoming new series, Perspectives. You get a little bit of a sneak peek of what I shot there. The first episode is set in the astonishing Dolomites. It's a mountain range in northern Italy, and it will drop here on YouTube soon, most likely in October. So now is a good time to hit that subscribe button and join the notification mob by ringing the bell, and you'll be notified when I upload my next video. So, the very first step in every correction process is to adjust the contrast. For that, you want to pull up the Luma waveform monitor in your editing software. In Final Cut Pro, simply hit Command and 7. The waveform monitor allows you to see how light or dark your image is across the entire frame. 0 is the darkest black and 100 is the brightest white. In most instances, you don't want your image to crush above or burn below this range. Next, you want to pull down the brightness of your shadows so that the darkest parts of your image just hit 0, and pull up the highlights so that the brightest parts of the image hit 100. To achieve this, I'll be using the color wheels. Alternatively, you can also use color curves, whatever you feel most comfortable with. So the nice thing about using an editing palette like the Loupedeck Plus is that most of them have a dedicated knob for contrast, which automatically lifts the highlights and drops the shadows. From there, you can just do some fine tuning with the shadow and highlight knobs, and boom, you can already see why colorists are using control surfaces like this because it just is so much more efficient. I definitely prefer turning knobs over a mouse or touchpad, it's just more precise and satisfying. Oh yeah, it's satisfying. I mean, listen to that. Ooh, wow. For a well-balanced and well-exposed image, we want to adjust the midtones next. And here our old pal and photography pro, Ansel Adams, comes to the rescue. Ansel came up with the zone system to assist in the proper exposure of analog film photography back in the days. This zone system determined accurately the exposure values for common objects, like humans, on a scale from 0 to 10, and 0 to 10 is equivalent to the 0 to 100 IRE values that you see on your waveform monitor. In this zone system, Caucasian skin tones like my pale face here fall into zone 7, about 74 IRE. This is where you want the skin tones to land, and ideally you already considered this during the shoot. So actually right now, as I'm shooting, I have a monitor up here and pulled up the waveform monitor to make sure that my skin tones fall into the 74 IRE range. A little bonus tip in the editing process, you may want to mask out the skin tones, the face of your subject, and adjust the midtones until you hit 74 IRE, and et voila, you have the perfect skin tone exposure. With the contrast out of its way, we are now set to move on to adjust the color, and oh boy, color is much, much more difficult. A helpful tool for us to recreate the natural color spectrum we saw when we filmed this is the vectorscope. Our eyes and computer screens deceive us every day, in particular when it comes to color. So you may wonder now, Joey, what is a freaking vectorscope? And I can tell you, a vectorscope is a neat visual representation of what is going on in terms of colors in your image so that you can see if your image is biased towards a certain color. Simply put, a well-balanced image gravitates towards the center of the scope. If they're out of whack, tweak the colors again using the color wheels. On the Loupedeck, if you hit the custom mode button, you can easily adjust the colors of the shadows, mids, and high. The best starting point are the highlights, which often fixes a lot of problems, especially if you didn't nail the white balance in camera. And yes, I'm guilty of that. I'm doing this all the time. Eyes are freaking deceptive. You can also use, obviously, a color checker and white balance card like this one to help you out to nail the white balance. But sometimes you just don't have the time or the tools with you. From the highlights, you work yourself through the midtones and the shadows. If you have a person in your shot, the midtones become particularly important since this is where the skin tones lay. Luckily, in your vectorscope monitor of your editing software, you can enable the skin tone line, which is reflective of the skin tone color, no matter what ethnicity. Here again, we apply a mask to the face to just focus on the subject's skin tones and adjust them until they line up with the skin tone line. Lastly, in the color correction process, and that's a quick one, is saturation. If you shoot in log, you will definitely have to dial up the saturation quite a bit, but don't go overboard. You want to achieve a natural looking image, and also make sure that all your shots are matching. With the Loupedeck, you have actually also multiple dials to navigate your timeline, making it easier to skip just a few frames or right to the next clip, making color matching just a tad faster. Okay, all in all, remember, in the color correction stage, you want to achieve a matching, natural, true-to-life look across all your images and nothing stylized. That is happening next in the color grading. Alright, so you've done your homework. Now to the dessert, the satisfying part where you can get creative and find the right look for your project. I follow these general two steps. Select a LUT as a starting point and then tweak the look and clean it up from there. But as a first step, I add an adjustment layer for the color grade that we are building out, since you can easily scale it out to the entire project and also keeps your timeline a little bit more cleaner. Then as the next step, simply add the custom LUT effect in Final Cut Pro to the layer and start trying out some of your favorite LUTs. You can find free LUTs all over the internet, or invest a little money and buy LUT sets. Among my personal favorites are actually those that emulate classic film looks like the Fuji or Kodak films. As you're exploring and creating your own look, keep the core learnings from color theory in mind, as it would help you to produce a more balanced color scheme for your image. Using the color wheel and your dominant color as a starting point, you have various options to achieve a pleasant color contrast. From monochromatic like The Matrix and analogous like Grand Budapest Hotel to triadic like the 70s Superman movie and complementary like Mad Max. If you know the rules, you can of course break them. So-called color discordance is the deliberate decision to deviate from the balanced movie color schemes. Examples here are Amelie with the color blue or even more extreme Sin City. The choice is all yours. The most popular color scheme though in cinema is the complementary color contrast of orange and teal because of its harmonious relationship between orange skin tones and a bluish, teal-ish background. It just makes the subject stand out more and the audience knows where to focus on. So thanks for coming on this quick detour in color theory, but once I'm happy with the LUT and adjusted its intensity, I'm going to tweak the look to adjust it just to my vision and make the look mine. What I love about the Loupedeck and editing panels at this stage in the process is that it allows you, even if you have just one screen, to manipulate the image in a full screen mode. You don't need to have the dials in to use your mouse. This is perfect as you go into the final treatment of your image. And finally, the last step in the color grading process that I do all the time, and it's my last tip, open the hue versus saturation curves and remove the color out of your shadows and your highlights so that your blacks are actually black and your whites are white. I know it's a minor detail, but as everything we've discussed in this video today, every little step contributes to the bigger picture to achieve a wonderful look that aids your story and elevates your work. Now to the part that you've been waiting for. How can you get a Loupedeck Plus? Well, it's super easy. Step one, join the notification mob by simply smashing that subscribe button and ringing the bell. And then step two, let us know in the comments below why you should get your hands on a Loupedeck Plus. The most creative answer wins. Sub, ring, comment, easy, right? Okay. Now at this stage, a big thank you to our friends at Loupedeck in Finland for creating an affordable editing panel and also making this giveaway possible. Now I absolutely cannot wait to hear from you guys and send that Loupedeck Plus to you. Woo! I will announce the winner in about 3 weeks' time from now in one of my next videos, so stay tuned. Do you have any color grading tips? Was this video helpful? What else do you want to see? Let us know in the comments below. I want to know. Thanks so much for watching. Have a good evening. Have a good morning, wherever, whenever you are around this beautiful planet. Bye-bye. I'm doing it. The dog is drinking. Give me 1 second. Keep drinking, we do some ASMR. We're doing some dog ASMR here. Okay, let's rewind.